Good evening, everyone, and welcome. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Well, as we come together this evening, we welcome all your families with us, and we celebrate with Ben, and with Adam, and with Caden, and all your families, as we welcome them to the table of the Lord to receive their first Holy Communion. As we come together on this beautiful summer evening, we pause to thank God for all of his gifts, especially the gift of these three boys, as they prepare to receive Jesus for the first time. You are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father in heaven, we pray that you will graciously pour out your Holy Spirit upon these three boys who prepare to receive the gift of the Eucharist for the first time. May you watch over them and their families. Help them always to trust in the power of your love and always know the goodness of your Son, Jesus, who lives with you and among us forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Let us be seated as Caden comes forward to share our first reading this evening.
Reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, when we drink from the cup that we ask God to bless, isn't that sharing in the blood of Christ? When we eat the bread that we break, isn't that sharing in the body of Christ? By sharing in the same loaf of bread, we become one body, even though there are many. The word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, I am the bread come down from heaven. Everyone who eats this bread will live forever. My flesh is the life-giving bread that I give to the people of this world. They started arguing with each other and asked, how can he give us his flesh to eat? Jesus answered them, I tell you for certain that you will not live unless you eat the flesh and drink the blood of the Son of Man. But if you do eat my flesh and drink my blood, you will have eternal life, and I will raise you on the last day. My flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. If you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you are one with me, and I am one with you. The living Father sent me, and I have life because of him. Now everyone who eats my flesh will live because of me. The bread that comes down from heaven is not like what your ancestors ate. They died. But whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Well, as we come together this evening, we're very excited for each of you boys and your families. You know, you are the first class to receive the gift of Jesus in the Eucharist in this new church. And so we're very proud of you. And we will remember that. And I think it's special that it's you three boys that come together with your families this evening. And what we celebrate is what Jesus speaks to us of the gospel. The best gift we can give these boys and your families is the gift of the Eucharist. Because what Jesus says is, my gift to you is my body, and I will live in you forever. And that's what Jesus promises us, is that he remains with us, and we remain in him. And I never want anyone to forget that, because God always loves us. Sometimes we may doubt God's love, or we may stray away, making other choices. But in the sacrament of reconciliation and in the gift of the Eucharist, Jesus always brings us back. And that's what we celebrate tonight. And so we're very proud of you that you've come this far and that you all look so sharp this evening. And so we want to celebrate with you and your families the goodness of God and how Jesus is always present with us. And the best way that we can thank him is by living out his love in how we care for others, in how we forgive others, and how compassionate we are to each other. And so as we continue our Mass this evening, and in a few moments you will receive the body of Christ for the first time, we ask God's blessings upon you and your family, that you will always remember the goodness of God's love deep within. So now I invite us all to stand as Ben comes forward to share our petitions with us this evening. You know, this evening we receive a very special gift from Jesus when he shares us his body for the first time. Let us now present our petitions to God as we celebrate our first Holy Communion this evening.
For all the boys and girls in our parish and in the world who will be receiving Jesus for the first time, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parents, godparents, friends, and teachers who love us and have prepared us for this great day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor and homeless children in our community and in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who want to be here in the church with us but are not able, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us here today, that we recognize the greatest gift we are ever to receive in the Eucharist, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our St. James community and for our church around the world, that we grow as one body in Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, we ask you to hear these needs, that with great faith, hope, and love, we offer upon your altar as we celebrate First Holy Communion with these boys and their families. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us be seated. Please stand. My friends, let us pray that our gifts might be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Father in heaven, from all you give us, we offer you these simple gifts. As we celebrate with these three boys and their families this evening, may all of us yearn for the coming of your Son, Jesus, into our hearts through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus your Son. For at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. He nourishes us by this sacred mystery and makes us holy, so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so together, with all the angels and saints, we acclaim. Please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, that by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint James and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And together we stand as we pray in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer an exchange of peace.
Take away the sins of the world.
Please kneel. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us stand and pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for these boys and their families who have received the gift of your heavenly bread for the first time. May you watch over them, fill them with the spirit of your love, and guide them always to be one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God bless you and keep you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
And before we close, let's congratulate these boys on a very special night. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.